In this video, I want to talk about the Enterprise Master Patient Index, or the EMPI. So what is an EMPI? Now, when a hospital, you know, or a healthcare system begins with one application, you usually have only one patient index, and that's usually just called the MPI. But when there are multiple applications, what tends to happen is that the same patient may be represented in different ways or using different identifiers across these different applications. And Murphy's rule or Murphy's law states that, you know, if something can go wrong, it will go wrong. So it's only a matter of time before the same patient gets represented in two different systems in slightly different ways, using different identifiers or different, slightly different name. Maybe it might be a typo. And this is actually really dangerous, because what happens is that when another application then wants to retrieve all information about this patient, and a practitioner wants to know everything about this patient, some vital information might be lost, because that information may be entered under another patient record, which again happens to link to the same real patient, but because computers are dumb and they don't really know, you don't get all the information that you actually want. So that's where an EMPI comes in, or an Enterprise Master Patient Index. So its job is pretty simple. It talks to all the applications in the system. So here we are seeing, for example, a diagnostic imaging system, a public health system, the lab system, and so on. And it makes sure that all these applications represent, you know, the patient itself in the EMPI. And the EMPI has sophisticated algorithms that it can then use to, you know, link duplicate patients and make sure that if duplicate patients do arise, they are linked and all of the data of this particular patient can be retrieved from multiple different systems. So again, the EMPI system works on protocols mostly laid by IHE. So they have the patient profiles specifically for this. So one is the cross identification profile, and another is just the patient query, the PICS profile. We're not going to go too deep into this in this particular video, but do let me know if you're interested. I can make another video on that. So I just want to talk about how you can configure an EMPI. So basically, you have these things called matching rules, which essentially tell an EMPI that, hey, two patients with these particular criteria may be the same. You may want to link it automatically if you're confident enough, but if you're not, then bring it up and a person can manually look through these possible potential matches and then link them, right? So an example of this would be if a name sounds similar and the patient is born in approximately the same date of birth range, then maybe they are the same patient and you may want to look at that and look at the confidence score. If it's above certain confidence score, then maybe just link it automatically and let people know that you've linked it. But if not, bring it up to another administrator who can then look at it and link it. Now, doing this at a scale and doing this on millions of patients, you can imagine that you need to compare every patient with every other patient. So it becomes a huge number of permutations and combinations. So that's why you also have this thing called blocking rules in a lot of systems. And what blocking rules essentially are is a way to tell the system that these two patients, or, you know, this criteria, use this criteria to kind of narrow down which patients you compare. So for example, if two patients are of completely different genders and they are born in completely different states or even different countries, then don't even bother comparing their names, right? So blocking rules are a way to instruct the Enterprise Master Patient Index that don't bother comparing all patients. You know, you have this blocking rule. You can eliminate most of the comparisons using this blocking rule. And then for the patients who are left, use the matching rule and then compare them and see if two patients may indeed be the same. Now, I want to take you through an example. So for example, something might, for example, Sidharth can be represented using two different spellings. And I always see people actually Making a mistake, especially when I go to the hospital, they usually, when they ask for my name, they might misspell it or mistype it. And in one system, it might be a particular name, and in another system, it might be something completely different. So how do you make sure that, you know, if somebody comes in with a name mistake like this and the Enterprise Master Patient Index is receiving the patient records from all these different systems, how can it determine that these are actually close by? So for names, you have this thing called a few algorithms. So you have one called the Gyro Winkler algorithm. So I'm just going to open it up for you to see here. So here, this is the Gyro Winkler distance. Basically, it's a Wikipedia article, but it has a lot of you know, details. But then it basically is how many strings, how many characters do you need to edit before you get another one. So in this case, if we had to take a look at, you know, Sidharth versus Sidharth, it's just a matter of one H that has to be edited to a D in order to get that. So the Gyro-Winkler distance would be one, right? It's a very small distance. Whereas, you know, again, the Winkler similarity basically just overlays on the Gyro algorithm and makes sure that if two names are starting with the same characters and so on, then the score is even higher, right? So it's actually represented as a point score, not exactly an integer score. But there is also another algorithm called the metaphone algorithm. So in this, they do a lot of procedural things. For example, drop all the duplicate characters and then use the phonetic sound of a particular thing to represent all words using just these symbols, right? So I'll show you an example of how this looks like. So I came across this metaphone generator. So for example, let's take a look at SIDHARTH and I generate the metaphone code. It will be STHR0. But if I do SIDDARTH, it will be STR0. So even if I do, for example, SIDDHARTH, this has the same metaphone code as SIDHARTH. It's exactly the same, right? So using this, computers can easily say that, okay, this name is exactly the same. But even if it's not exactly the same, it can use the metaphone algorithm along with the Gyro-Winkler distance, for example, to immediately determine that, oh, okay, this might actually be the same name. It might belong to the same patient. Okay, let's bring it up to another human or an administrator to then link these together so that when you then search for all records of this patient, you get everything and you don't lose out on something just because one person decided to make a typo on SIDH versus SIDD, right? These are, you know, few ways in which you can compare patients. Now let's take a look at what open source libraries or what tools are out there that you can actually use today, right? So one of this, again, I'm moving to my screen. So one of this is the Open EMPI project. So now this is open source up till a certain version. So if you go to the resources and actually go to their documentation page, you can see all the versions that are available. And again, you can download their, all of the versions till 3.5 are open source. And after that, it's enterprise only, which kind of sucks. But then they are maintaining the older versions well, and it's a Java project, and you do have to kind of sign in here before you are able to download I forgot my password, but you got to register and you can sign in, and you'll get the all of the files, the jar files that you need to run the project. So it has its UI and it's pretty decent. Does what it needs to do. It works with the IHE profiles. Now, another very interesting open source project is actually the Happy Fire server. So the Happy Fire server has a module which used to be called the EMPI module, but now it's called the MDM or the Master Data Management module. And this is really interesting because it actually has a lot of, you know, you can configure these blocking and you can configure these matching rules. And even the things that I talked about, like Metaphone, Gyro-Winkler, and it's pretty sophisticated. And you can do all of this and you can say which is a possible match and which is, which is a immediate match, so it can automatically do it. And it works natively with FHIR patient resources. So you can just create FHIR patients and you can then configure the Happy FHIR MDM to immediately say that these two patients might be the same. So that's really cool in my opinion. And if you want me to do another video diving deep into how to set up MDM and how to configure the rules and how it exactly works, it has this, you know, enterprise identifiers and the golden resource and so on. It has a lot of important concepts. So if you want me to break that down, maybe, you know, let me know in the comments. I can do that in another video. But yeah, this video was just about the enterprise master patient index, or an EMPI, what it does, how it works, and how you can get started with one today with, you know, open source projects. Take open EMPI for a spin, or if you prefer, you can even try out the Happy Fires MDM module. So thanks again for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.